Welcome, dear students. Today we will discuss closed set and their properties with example and theorem. So, dear students,
closed set. Closed sets and their properties.
For discussing this, first of all, we have to know the definition of closed set. So, definition of closed set. Definition one. A subset S of R, is said to be closed if its complement S dash or S complement is open. So a set is said to be closed if its complement is open. Definition two of closed set. A subset S of R, that is, S is a subset of R, is said to be closed if it contains all of its limiting points. To understand this definition, we have to know what is limiting point. So before knowing limiting points, we cannot understand this completely. So today we just proceed with this definition. By following the definition number one, we are going to check whether the set of real numbers R is closed. And the question is that the set of real numbers R is closed or not. To answer this question, we have to check the complement of R. Here, the complement of R equal to, we know that complement of any set is equal to R minus this set. So R minus R is an empty set. And we know that empty set is an open set, which is open. So, since our complement is open, so by definition we can say that R is closed. Therefore, R is closed set. The another question is that a null set is closed or not? Question number two. The empty set ORI is closed or not? Closed or not? So dear student, we can proceed in this similar way. Here, complement of null set equal to R minus null set, which is R. We have to check the complement of null set. That is, complement of null set equal to R minus null set, and that is R, which is open. We know that R is open and also R is closed. Since R is open, then Q is a closed set. Therefore, Q is a closed set. Since Q complement, null set complement is set of real number which is open, then null set is closed. That is, null set is closed set. Dear students, we have got two important properties of closed sets, and it is both the set of real number and the empty set are closed set, as well as these two sets are also open sets. Therefore, the important properties of closed sets are the set of real numbers. The set of real numbers R and the empty set ORI both are closed set as well as open sets. Open set. These properties are very important properties of closed sets, also open sets. Now let us take an example on finite set, which will be closed set. We take an example. Suppose S equal to 1, 2 and 3, which is a finite set. Now we are going to check whether it is closed. By definition, if it is a closed set, then its complement S should be open set. Here we can draw a real line and put this number on this real line. Suppose this quadrant is 1, this quadrant is 2, this quadrant is 3, and this set is divided by S. Now if we check its complement, so we have a complement of S equal to minus infinity to 1, minus infinity to 1, and it is an open interval. Again, a union of minus infinity to 1, then 1 to 2, then 2 to 3, and then 3 to infinity. So it is clear that the complement of S, that is S prime or S dash, equal to the union of infinite collection of or the union of arbitrary collection of open sets. You know that the union of arbitrary collection of open sets is also an open set. So we can say that here S dash is open. S dash is open. Since S dash is open, then by definition we can say that therefore S is a closed set. So dear students, any finite set will be a closed set. That's because this finite set is closed set. And in the previous example, we saw that the empty set phi is also a closed set, that which is finite set. So we can say that any finite set is a closed set. So we have achieved an important property of closed set, and it is every finite set is a closed set. Every finite set is closed set. Another most important property is any finite set is closed set. Now we take another example, which is an infinite set but not an interval. Example 2. We take an example on infinite set, which is infinite but not interval. This is actually a set of natural numbers. So if we take its complement, a complement equal to all real numbers except these elements. All real numbers except a. So we can say that this will be minus infinity to 1 union 1 to 2 union 2 to 3 union 3 to 4 union and so on. So here we see that it is an open set. Also it is an open set. All of these intervals are open sets. So dear students, follow. What does it indicate? It indicates that the arbitrary collection or the union of arbitrary collection of open sets, we know that the union of arbitrary collection of open set is also an open set. So we can say that which is open. Since a complement is open, then we can say that A is closed. So it implies that A is closed. And this example, just like the example, previous example. So we can say that any finite infinite set which is not an interval is also a closed set. So another property is every infinite set which is not an interval is closed set. This is very important properties of closed set. Dear students, you should keep it in our mind that this theory has some limitations. That is, it will not work for some special cases. As for example, the set of rational number Q and its complement irrational number and some other set we find which are infinite and not interval, but they are not also closed sets. And such type of set will be discussed in later. However, with the help of this example, we can say that the set of natural numbers, the set of integers, set of whole numbers, these are closed sets. Another property is the set of natural numbers, another most important property, the set of natural numbers, set of integers, set of whole numbers, the sets are closed sets. Now we will work on intervals. First of all, we take a closed interval. A closed interval. Closed interval. Or any closed interval. Any closed interval is closed. So we see that why it is closed. On real line, we take an interval, suppose closed interval, sorry, closed interval, suppose it is 2 to 7. Now, we indicate this by S equal to 2 to 7. Here, the complement of S will be all real numbers except the real numbers lying between 2 and 7, including 3 and 7. That is, S gets equal to R minus 2 to 7. The result is minus infinity to 2 union 7 to infinity. So it is clear that minus infinity to 2 is an open set. Also, 7 to infinity is an open set. And we know that the union of two open sets is also an open set. So we can say that as this is perfect. Which is open. Since it is open, so by definition we said that 2 to 7 closed interval is closed. So easily we can prove it, and we can say every closed interval or any closed interval is closed. Again, if we consider this interval is an open interval, then we see what will be happened. This interval is 2 to 7, which is an open interval. So its complement will be minus infinity to, this is excluded, F is included, also 7 is included. So we know that open closed or closed open interval is not an open. So their union will not be open set. It is not open. Since S complement is not open, so S is not closed. Therefore, 2 to 7, therefore 2 to 7 open interval is not closed. So easily we can say that any open interval is not a closed set. And the similar words is applicable for open closed interval and closed open interval. So we can say that any interval which is not closed, that is open interval, open closed interval and closed interval, all these intervals are not closed. So any interval which is not closed is not closed set. Most important property. We are trying to accumulate some properties along with them in here. In the previous example, we proved that the set of real numbers R and empty set I both are open as well as closed. R and I both are open as well as closed. Also, we proved in here open closed interval and closed open interval, these are also not open as well as not closed. So open closed interval may be any open closed interval, and any closed open interval is neither open nor closed. So it could be open closed interval and it could be closed open interval are neither open nor closed set. Also, there is another important property of closed sets. The set of rational number Q and set of irrational number Q times, these are also not open set as well as not closed set. So Q and Q dash, set of real number and set of rational number and set of irrational number are not open as well as closed set. Now we discuss on these properties, that is the set of rational number and the rational number are not closed set. In the previous video, we talked that Q is not an open set. The set of rational number is not an open set. Now we are going to prove the set of rational number is not a closed set. The set of rational number is not closed set. The set of rational numbers. Rational numbers Q is not closed. To prove this theorem or property, we can take the help of Venn diagram. Suppose it is set of a real number. So now that it contains two type of numbers. Then one is rational, the other is irrational number. So suppose this is Q, set of rational number, and this set is Q complement, which is set of irrational number. Now, if we take a point from this set of rational number, so suppose here is the number x0, which is 2. Now, if we consider a neighborhood of this element, we can say that the neighborhood is x0 minus epsilon 2, x0 plus epsilon. And that is, which is 2 minus, suppose, epsilon equal 0.1. 2 minus 0.1 is 2 plus 0.1. And this is 1.92, 2.1. And we know that any interval contains infinite number of rational numbers as well as irrational numbers. And it also contains algebraic number and transcendental number. So we see that Q is not neighborhood of X0. That's because X0, neighborhood of X0 is 1.92, 2.1, which contains infinite number of irrational number. That is, we can say that a neighborhood of X0 is like stars. So, neighborhood of X0 contains infinite number of irrational numbers. Q cannot be called a neighborhood of X0. That is, Q is not open. Now, if we take a point from Q complement here, suppose an element y is 0 and left y is equal, 12, left y is equal, 12, square root 2. If we consider neighborhood of square root 2, that is y dot minus epsilon 2, y dot plus epsilon. So similarly, we can say that this interval contains infinite number of rational numbers. So the neighborhood of y dot like this. That is, this neighborhood contains an infinite number of rational numbers. which are not included in irrational number. So we can say that a Q complement is not an open set. So since Q complement is not open, then Q is not closed. So we can easily prove that QC is not closed. QC is not open, so which implies that Q is not closed. Similarly, we can prove that Q complement, that is set of irrational number, cannot be an open set, cannot be a closed set. So therefore, the set of rational numbers is not closed set. And it is a very nice explanation, I think. This can helps us to understand this theorem also for irrational number. The students here, I think they will say, Q is not neighborhood of any of its squares. So Q is not open. Q complement is also neighborhood of any of its squares. So Q complement is not open. Since Q complement is not open, then by definition of closed set, Q cannot be closed. Since Q cannot be open, so its complement, Q complement is not open. So Q and Q complement both are neither open. Theorem one. The union of two closed set is also closed, as like the theorem on open sets. The intersection of two closed sets is also closed. The intersection of an arbitrary collection of open sets is also arbitrary collection of closed sets is also closed, but the infinite collection of closed sets need not to be closed. And the rest is the union of finite collection of closed set is also closed set. So dear students, I think you can prove them in the evidence of in case of open sets. But we take an example on this theorem to prove the union of infinite collection of open sets need not to be closed. Okay, I am going to prove two theorems of them. One is number two, and another is number four. So we are going to prove these two theorems. The intersection of two closed sets is also closed. the union of infinite collection of closures is going to be closed. Now we can example. Now we are going to prove theorem number 2. Theorem number 2. That is the intersection of two closed sets is also a closed set. To prove this theorem, let An B are two closed sets. Since both A and B are closed, then we can say that here both their complements are open sets. And here A complement and B complement are open sets. Since these are open, their complement A and B are closed. Who is implied that by set theory, A complement and B complement are open sets implies that A complement union B complement is an open set. Is an open set. By set theory, you can say that. This implies A intersection B complement, we can say that by De Morgan's law of set theory. Therefore, A intersection B complement is an open set. Open set by De Morgan's law. By De Morgan's law, we can say such. Now, if A intersection B complement is open, so by definition, we can say that A intersection B is closed set. So, by definition, we can say A intersection B is closed. Hence, the theorem is closed. Hence, the theorem is closed. Very easy and simple. Now we are going to prove theorem number 4 with an example. And this theorem was the union of infinite collection of closed sets need not to be closed. The union of infinite collection of closed sets need not to be closed. To prove this theorem, we can take an example. Let S n equal 1 by n to 1. Here, n belongs to set of natural numbers. Now, if we take infinite collection of closed sets from this set, we get S1 equal if we put 1 for n, we get only one number, that is 1 to 1 integral, that is, it is only one number 1 here. And S2 equal 1 by 2 to 1. S3 equal 1 by 3 to 1. And so on. Follow dear students, where what will be happen, we see that this number gradually will goes to smaller and it approaches to zero. That is, this number tends to goes to or approaches to zero. Now, if we take union of infinite collection of these closed sets, we get that union of infinite collection of closed sets, that is S1, S1 union, S2 union, S3 and so on. So here S1 equal 1 union, half to 1 union, 1/3 to 1 and union and so on. Here one thing is important, this number is, or this element is decreasing and goes to zero, but not exactly zero. So we can say that the union of this infinite collection of closed sets is half to 1. Sorry, 1 by n. This element, first element of integral goes to 0. And the highest element is 1. So we can say that this goes to an interval 0 to 1, which is open closed interval. And we very much clear that open closed interval is neither open nor closed. So it is not, which is not open set. Open set and which is not closed. So it is closed. So we can say that the union of infinite collection of processes is not to be closed. And therefore, the union of infinite collection of closed sets need not to be closed. So, my dear students, I put my discussion here, and thank you everyone, and inviting you to watch the next video on another topic.